Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. In behalf of the Osamis Chamber of Commerce and Industry Foundation Incorporated, would like to express our profound gratitude for your positive support for attending this afternoon's meeting. I understand this is a meeting with the Chamber of Commerce and Industry, especially with Peter Paul Cocoa Plant, the biggest in the world in terms of coconut production. And of course, one of the most important guests that we will have this afternoon is also the participation of the 1002nd Maneuver Company. So in behalf of the Chamber, I would like to welcome each one of you. And we hope we will have a fruitful meeting this afternoon. Thank you.
So we have our first speaker for today. We have invited the plant manager of Peter Paul. I think everyone knows already Peter Paul, the new coconut factory that is being built in Plaridel. They have their base in Candelaria, Quezon. 76 years na din sila. Then, saan yung isa?
One in Sorsogon City.
So they also have another one in Sorsogon, and this is the third. So anyway, ang atong plant manager will expand on what they have right now. And kung doon na may questions later on, at bangutana na lang mo ha. Sige. I would like to introduce, of course, the plant manager, Mr. J.V. Santos.
Hello, good afternoon, everyone. So first of all, thank you very much for inviting me into this afternoon meeting. So first of all, I'm J.V. Santos, the factory manager of Peter Paul Philippine Corporation, or much known as the Consolidated Coconut Corporation that's being built in Plaridel, Misamis Occidental. So the Consolidated Coconut Corporation, so our capacity for the operation will be around 350,000 kilos of coconut per day. So assuming 1 kilogram of coconut per one piece of coconut, so that's equivalent also to 350,000 pieces of coconut running for 24/7 days a week. So we will be needing a manpower of around more or less 900 to 1,000 for the 24/7 operation. So as a background for the Peter Paul Philippine Corporation, so we have 3 plants. So one in Candelaria, Quezon. So majority of the products there are desiccated coconut, coconut water, virgin coconut oil. We have coconut butter and any more. So Peter Paul Philippine Corporation is the biggest manufacturer of high value coconut products. And we sell our products 95% mainly to United States, Europe, Australia, China, and some in Middle East. So for the Consolidated Coconut Corporation, it's the third plant. So it is very strategic because 2 plants namin nasa Luzon. So just in case there's a problem with the supply of coconut, we have at least 1 coconut in the south area of the Philippines so we can remain supply our customers.
If you're going to buy the coconut, are you going to buy the land from the producer directly, or you go to another third person?
Yeah, that's a good question. That's a good question, sir. So right now, our strategy for the nuts buying station is we have 2 major sources of coconut. Number one, we will be establishing our own buying station. There's a selected location for the Misamis Occidental and Zamboanga del Norte. And the second one, we have a supplier of coconuts that can direct delivery to our plant. So we have only one guy. That's our assistant nuts buying procurement manager for the coconut. So he will be handling our own buying stations, and then the second one, the accreditation of the big suppliers.
So in case of selling the coconut, so are you going to sell it on the coconut shell, or is it going to call it in the camera, or
it's already the husk coconut, the whole coconut, the husk. Yes. So no more drying. So it's very different from the copra. So yung product namin is high value product. So we will be needing the husk coconut, the whole coconut. Because ang difference ng copra, the copra is dry using the traditional method or sometimes yung tapahan. But for our product, number one, we have desiccated coconut that's oven dry or oven baked desiccated coconut. And then we will be using the coconut water for the 1-inch Tetra Pak. So that's also sold internationally.
So in the coconut, we are not going to categorize or precise the coconut, for example, small, medium, large?
No. We will be buying coconut in kilos.
Kilos?
Yes. Of the has coconut in kilos, but there were specifications like our criteria, the whole coconut, the husk coconut should be not less than 0.7 kilogram per piece. And then the shape of it must be round. Hindi pwede yung mga oblong. So yun lang naman yung major criteria namin for the coconut.
Is there a specific variety of coconut na that you guys will only accept?
Okay. For the coconut trees, there's no variety na specification namin. As long as it meets the requirement that it is round, its weight is not less than 0.7 kilogram, it is acceptable to our plant. So any variety of coconut.
How about the coconut water?
Yeah, there's no problem also. Yes, no problem. Yes, no problem with the variety. Yeah. Our. Yes. Okay. Yeah. So. Okay. There will be difference in prices. So we will be having plant gate price. So that's the price na kapag nag-deliver directly to our plant. But we will be having also a buying station price na ibabawas namin directly yung presyo ng logistics only. So the market of our own buying station, mainly yung mga farmers, direct farmers delivery to our buying station. But for the suppliers, this one yung mga big traders, big suppliers na that they have the logistics. They have the machinery to transport mga around 10,000, 20 tons of coconut a day directly to our plant. Yes, correct. Currently, we have 9 proposed buying stations, but that is not final yet. For the Misamis Occidental, so I can enumerate it. So we have buying station in Ozamis, Tudela, Jimenez, Oroquieta, and maybe in Calamba. And then for Zamboanga del Norte, we will be having maybe in Dapitan, Rojas, and Rizal. Yeah. So that's 8 buying stations or maybe 9. In Ozamis, near Intangu. Yeah, because that's the area where there's a lot of coconuts near Tangub. But nothing is final yet for the buying stations because our operation, our target for now, based on our assessment, that would be around July, end of July the earliest. So the operation might get delayed also.
Is it necessary that we have to go through the agent buying station or we can go directly to your plant?
Yeah, so that's a good question, ma'am. So just that depends on the volume of the coconut that you can deliver. So just in case, you will be delivering not more than 5,000 or at least the distance from the buying station to the plant. If it's not economical for you to deliver directly to our plant, maybe it's best to deliver to our buying stations.
Talking about the supply of national.
Okay. Mani Pinyon.
The other time,
that is also correct, admin. So for the items that you have discussed, so our sourcing of coconut will be not limited to Misamis Occidental and Zamboanga del Norte, but those areas will be our priority. So we will be also sourcing from Lanao areas, from other areas like Zamboanga del Sur or other areas, but our priority mainly is Misamis Occidental and Zamboanga del Norte first. Yes. So we highly appreciate that, admin. So as much as possible, we want to run our plant at the most optimum capacity. So we really need the coconuts to fulfill our 350 tons capacity per day. That's a good question also. So for the whole coconut, for the coconut industry, so I have to discuss this. Generally, 85% of the coconut is 85% of the coconut produce is for coconut cooking oil. So 50% only is for high value products like our plant that is producing coconut desiccated, coconut water, and virgin coconut oil. So we do praise our pricing based on the copra price. So the copra price, so as much as possible, we remain above the copra price, and as much as possible, we have to pay the farmers or the suppliers within the day. And then for the difference, for the copra, they have to dry it before they can sell. While for the coconut, the husk coconut, upon harvesting, they can sell us directly. So the turnover of the cash flow, much less easier, much less shorter.
Any more question? Ano mga coconut planters niya?
Can you discuss a little bit more on the variety of coconut acceptable sa inyo? And then where can we get
So for the variety of coconut, we don't have really specific variety. So
can you give us like what's acceptable for the
classic? Ang acceptable namin is at least the size or the shape is round only. And then the kilogram, dapat hindi siya bumaba ng 0.7 kilogram per piece. Yes. So that's only our primary requirement for the coconut. So as long as it's coconut and its shape is round, it's not less than 0.7 kilogram, that's acceptable to us.
From your experience, is there a specific variety that alam niyo uses more than the other varieties?
For us, wala kaming ano eh. There's no specific variety talaga na pinipili namin. So as long as it's naturally grown coconut trees or even some yung mga hybrid coconut trees, as long as pasok dun sa ano namin requirement, that's acceptable talaga. But we have some in our programs, like we tested yung Orgulio coconut ng Zamboanga. But upon our during the report, so those coconuts vary depende sa kung saan area talaga siya na itanim. So parang it's different kung itong coconut nakatanim sa Zamboanga del Norte, and then kukunin mo yung variety of coconut, itatanim mo sa Candelaria, Quezon, or Sorsogon, yung upbringing ng coconut or the number of coconut trees, the number of coconut fruits it can bear might differ because magkaiba sila ng lupa. So it might not fit in other areas. So as much as possible, coconut dito to sa area, yun lang talaga yung kinukuha namin. There's no specific variety talaga. Because some trees, doon talaga siya maganda kung saan siya nakatanim.
May gusto na ako linawin, yung maging supply ko din yung video register, and then other benefits is the supplier to register in
your company. Yeah. Yeah, so we do accredit yung mga ano namin, mga coconut suppliers namin. So we do the profiling and then check the accreditation, the requirements. And then for the benefit, so we will be paying them based on our price that is based on our plant gate price.
So this will be for the accreditation.
Yeah, yes, we will be having accreditation also. That's a good question. So the ideal is 22%. So one coconut can yield 22% kapag ginawa mong copra. That's the ideal. Pero wala pa dyan yung bawas like moisture, may dust, may mga anything. Because we know copra ang daming bawas. So 22%, that's the ideal yield.
Yes.
Of copra. So our price will be vary depending on the market price of the copra, because the copra is 85% already of the market of the whole coconut. In our Sorsogon currently, it's in 1050 area. Yeah, 10 pesos and 50 cents for 1 kilo of coconut. Yeah. That's to give you an example. Yes. Yes. Yes, and then the turnover mas mabilis because after you harvest and then the husk, you can deliver it right away. Unlike for the copra, you need to dry it. You have a lot of manpower. So it will take time talaga before you can sell it. And then the quality of the copra that you can produce, baka mababa pa. There's a lot of bawas. Yeah, so that's the purpose of our own buying station, na we locate it strategically to different areas that at least the farmers can benefit the prices of our coconut. So at least we shoulder the logistics and then they can enjoy the price of the coconut. To collaborate with the PCA because they are the agency talaga na focus for the coconut. Just to reference, so one wing van that can hold around 20 to 22,000 coconut. 20,000 to 22,000 one wing van. Yeah.
One wing van then reverse.
Yes. So that can hold 20,000 to 22,000 kilogram of coconut. So, yeah, there will be changes in the prices because the market price will changes every week. So we have changes in the prices at least every Tuesday or when there's a significant changes in the prices. Sometimes kasi in just a week, the market price of the copra goes up terribly or goes down terribly. So we have to really adjust our prices.
So are you still remembering?
Yes, yes. And then not only the price of the copra, so we also depend our price on the demand or the supply of the coconut. Because if there's no much supply of coconut, so and our demand is fixed, so we have to really increase our price if there's no supply that's coming to our plant.
What is the plant operating right now?
Consolidated Coconut Corporation is ongoing construction, and our target, the earliest target for the operation will be end of July. Yes, this year of 2022. And then to add for the coconut requirement, I failed to say this, that our requirement for coconut is only 45 days old. Unlike for the copra, that sometimes they have 60 to 90 days bago nila i-harvest. So for us, 45 days only. Yeah, not less than 45 days. Okay. Yeah. Currently, we have a group of human resources that's pulling our requirement, and then we have a Facebook page where they can send through online their resumes, and then if they can go to our plant directly, so they can send also the resume in our plant.
Are you looking for engineers or office?
Yeah, there's a lot of engineers that we need. There's a lot of skilled, unskilled technical persons. So for the 1,000, majority of it were skilled and unskilled. So 60% may be unskilled.
So my operation on July, the 1,000 staff should be inside.
Yes, correct. That's the direct employees, but there were indirect employees like for the tracking services, because as we discussed, we will be having our own buying stations, that it will require manpower for the logistics and the buying stations. And if you have more clarification, so please feel free to go into our plant, just in case na hindi nyo naman siya na-clarify today. Our plant is open for clarification, for more collaboration and partnership. Sicho Kabalawan, Barangay Panalsalan, Plari del Misamis Occidental. On the average, ang nakikita namin from our buying station to the plant. Yeah. Ah, yeah. So, more or less, our estimate will be around 500 to 700 pesos per ton of coconut. Yes. 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 That's our computation. So, halimbawa, ang price namin sa plant is 10.50, so the price in Ozamis might be 10 pesos, parang ganun. But we will factor in, syempre, the distance din ng coconut. Not only the from the plant gate price, because sometimes we have these areas in Ozamis na sobrang layo sa Plaridel, might be our pricing for the Ozamis might differ in our plant gate price talaga. But on the standard, sa Sorsogon namin, the average is mga nasa around 500 to 700 per ton.
Here, the price is from farm to copper buying station, we're paying like 2 pesos per kilo. That's the transportation.
For the logistics?
Yes.
Yeah. So that's
how we motorcycle.
So our buying station, so yung 0.5 na yun is only the logistics, the cost of the logistics. So why we came up with that idea, to give really the farmers enjoy the price for our buying stations.
I have a question, Jay. Do you have agents in your other operations na yumaman?
Yeah, for our buying stations, so every buying station we have agent. So the payment of that will be based on the commission on how many coconut na natanggap ng isang buying station.
Meron nga nakita yung mama na...
Yeah, Yeah, we have ang umaman sa amin talaga in our oldest plant sa Candelaria namin. Ang umaman doon is the suppliers. And it got full blown na sometimes we can control the suppliers. So we have this second plant na itinayo sa Sorsogon. So nagkaroon kami ng buying station at least to control the big suppliers. So we want na yung relationship is hindi kami hawak ng supplier. So we have a common control. So that's why we have buying station and then we have the supplier. Because we are a big company, so as much as possible, we want the supply of coconut be safe. So we don't want na mag-usap lang yung mga ibang suppliers, wala nang dadating na nyog sa amin.
Any more question? Yes?
You made mention about the supply. There were two players in the market right now.
Yes.
So you're familiar with that?
Gain Coco.
And then yours, focusing on becoming continental as a model of North Bay. Sabi mo ka lang, you're bringing around 300,000 nuts per day. So I assume the capacity in our area is very, very limited. So my question is, does your company offers some sort of business support to local farmers, like, for instance, providing the seeds? So some contract growers.
Okay.
So we can come up with that one to ensure sustainability and business continuity in our plant operation.
Yeah.
Because I'm worried about that years from now, kung hindi ma-meet yung target volume, yung baka yung delivery yung plant.
Yeah, correct. Correct. Yes, correct.
In your processing plant. So that's why if you can check with your company sort of business partnership and local farmers in Interpol, we can come up with, kasi in terms of visit off and the one that the Lord we have a very vast area. Now maybe we can plant more. Please, because of worry ngayon, probably for most of our coconut trees are all aged than 50, we're talking of 50, 60 years old. Therefore, yung productivity output is very
low.
Say, 30, 40% capacity na lang. So, if we can support our farmers because now, if we will ask them to do replanting, it will be mostly. So, meron pa tayong resources intended for that.
So, for our Candelaria, I will give an example, yung planta namin, Candelaria and Sorsogon. So, we have replanting program.
Yung sa region, the area where Peter Polo operated, what's the economic impact in the community?
Yes. To give you an example in our Sorsogon plant, so that started only in 2012. So that's 10 years already, and then may malls na doon, there's an SM, there's Robinson, but before wala. Yes.
How about the environmental impact? Because we have impact sometime 2 years ago in Oroqueta, and then come to because of some environmental issues.
Yeah. So we have the, Dito, we have the wastewater management, we have the design talaga to treat our hazards, our waste before discharge it to the environment.
Because your area is in Panansalan, there are a lot of resources.
Yes, correct. Yeah. So we have a strong coordination with the EMB with regards to the parameters on kung ano ba yung recommended nila na standard that we have to design our wastewater treatment facility para at least we will meet those things and we won't have the pollution problems.
Sir, considering also that this is their third plant, no? Aniti na kailan sila alam na isa yung sa environmental impact, compliant na sila, kaya tulungan sila, pundahon sila.
Yes, and please feel free to visit our plant in Playa del Misamis Occidental if you have more clarifications, if meron kayong hindi natanong today. So feel free lang po.
Okay.
And if you have any business proposal or anything, you can discuss it to us.
Okay, so you got it, huh? Mm-hmm. If you have any problem, direkta lang mo ato sa ilang. Una mo yung mga business proposal nila, pwede gihapon. So, imba, especially this time na wala pa sila ng operate. Eh, basic pa, diba, the time that you start operating, daghan ng doon business proposal, pangwain na tao. Mr. Santos, thank you very much in behalf of the Osamis Chamber. Salamat. Thank you very much for coming. Then at least enlighten ang grupo, and I know that this will be disseminated to 1,000 more of people. We will be airing this over 2 TV stations. Araw-araw yon. Tsaka Brad, Nesty, thank you so much for bringing also JV here. I'll ask our president to say something.
So once again, in behalf of the Osamis Chamber, sir, thank you very much for being with us this afternoon. I hope that this will initiate a move, especially to our coconut planters, to plant more coconuts. And we know for a fact that on this side of Mindanao, there are so many people who are dependent on the coconut industry. As you can see, the economic cycle of Misamis Occidental revolves on coconut. So if you can help in providing a good future in the coconut industry, then we believe that there will be more money to circulate on this side of Mindanao, and in order to uplift the lives of people. So our coconut industry will provide us a good future. And let us continue to pray that this will be blessed, and that our planters will not be discouraged in planting coconut trees. We are also alarmed that so many people have become hopeless in their coconuts, cutting it and selling it to make more money or immediate cash. As you can see, people are in need of money nowadays. So with the programs that you have, sir, in your company, we hope that through the Chamber of Commerce, we can help uplift your industry and, of course, the lives of other people here in Misamis Occidental. Again, sir, thank you very much for coming.